Ray. What do you want to do tonight?
Same thing we do every night, Pinky. Try to take over the world.
Our first guest is a good example. She says she developed the power to attract money. Let's welcome Christine Hammond. Christine. What do you mean you can attract money?
Well, about 4 years ago, I had a very bad life. I had a very bad relationship. He was cheating on me all the time. It was a four-year relationship. I had a car that I could barely get down the street. I had a job that I absolutely hated, and I did not know what to do. I went to all kinds of seminars, here and there, positive thinking seminars, everything, and nothing really stuck.
So you were stuck in a life. A lot of people can relate to that. It's just things
exactly.
aren't going well.
And I didn't
can't
think
get
there
ahead.
Was anything wrong with it.
Yeah.
Which is even worse.
You thought that was normal yeah. life. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So how did you develop the ability to attract money?
Well, the last seminar I went to, and it was eight week seminar. By the end of the eighth week, I had a brand new car, a job with three times the salary, and a new relationship, a very empowering relationship.
Okay.
So everything shifted. In 8 weeks.
Your life. In 8 weeks,
in
you turned
weeks.
Your life around
mm-hmm.
financially.
Yes.
Well, is there a power over money that we can all master and become rich? I know I'm not going anywhere. Stay with us. Talking with Christine Hammond, who claims to have the power to attract money, and she is joined by the author of An Emergency Handbook for Getting Money Fast. Please welcome Carol Dore. Carol. This is a very appealing topic. How did you develop this idea? How?
I did. I saw the need, and there's definitely a need. I was one of the victimized women that are so many in this country where I really had a beautiful relationship for 10 years, and the last four was a nightmare. He started to do drugs, cocaine, stayed out every night till 4 o'clock in the morning for 4 years. There was another woman eventually I was to discover. And I couldn't leave him because I was very ill at the time, and I was mostly in bed, and I really started
Ill with what? What was wrong? Like just chronically ill?
I was chronically ill. Yeah. I was in and out of hospitals, and mm-hmm. they honestly at that point didn't really know what was wrong with me. Mm-hmm. I was just in and out. And
okay.
It was so tormenting because we were inseparable for 10 years, and he was just gone real quickly. And I was so sick, and that I just turned to positive thinking books, listened to tapes night and day. I tried to drown my thoughts out because I couldn't think of anything else to do.
Yeah.
And I did that for the first year to save my sanity. The second year, I was catching on to something, and I was lying there, and I was really figuring a lot of things out. By the third year, I really started to understand my powers.
What's your twist on visualization? Help us understand visualization.
Well, most what I discovered during this time was that it's all done mostly through the mind, and people trying to actually program themselves to draw to themselves, which when they realize that visualization is sort of using your imagination to create what you want in your life, and that when you have this type of energy within you, you start to draw things to you. So they start to program themselves to draw things to them. And my twist was that I realized that through the mind that came in and it would go out again. And so I learned how to do it through my heart.
So now apply this to money. How do you approach money differently?
Well, that's what happened was during this time, especially afterwards, was that I found out that I could draw money to me and that there were lots of people, as I was teaching classes for 8 years, 9 years, I saw that this was a real major problem with the money area. And so for myself, to stay in the beautiful big apartment, I needed to, after I got out of this marriage, I needed to create money very quickly. And I developed it for myself.
Now, you say that you can actually demonstrate positive vibrations and their effect on physical objects. You're going to show us something here?
Yes, I can. When you raise the vibrational energy, when you raise your energy level, your energy becomes stronger and things change rapidly. That's when you get into synchronicity.
Okay.
So what happens when I hold onto the spoon and my energy level changes, I can bend it. I can't right now, but I can with your help. And one of the highest vibrational energies is laughter. We're very powerful when we laugh. So what I'll do is I'll just, if I can, I'll tell you a real quick little story. And if you help me out, if you laugh to the story, I can bend my spoon here, and then you can watch this.
So you need to tell a story. You need us to
laugh
out loud.
I have to tell you the story
loud,
first, okay?
And then the vibration of our laughter is going to help her bend the spoon. You ready?
It's going to help a lot.
Okay, let's go.
Okay.
Get ready.
So, okay, after I left him, I managed to get into a gorgeous apartment in Newport Beach, and it was beautiful. I had been in there a while. I had a few years. I was rearranging the bedroom furniture in my bedroom, and I thought, gee, I've really got to rearrange the patio out there too, and there's a big tree about this big out there, and I thought, gee, I've really got to center that underneath the planter where it used to be, and I don't know how I'm going to do that because I'm not big enough to do it, and I got to get a man. I don't know who that's going to be, and it's going to take more than one. I know for sure I don't know who that's going to be. It took that long, okay, to think this through your mind, and I'm rearranging the furniture. Well, all of a sudden, not even 3 or 4 minutes later, this man's head pops up over the planter. Now, I'm on the third floor, so this is not normal. And looking in my bedroom is definitely not normal. So I'm looking, I scream, blood-curdling scream. He nearly falls off his ladder. And I said, what do you think you're doing? He says, I'm trying to clean the rain gutters above you. I'm with maintenance. And my partner and I were trying to do it up above. We couldn't get to them. We need to climb from down below. Do you mind if we use your patio to get to the next level? And I said, no, I said, that's okay, you can do that. And he says, yes, but we need to put our ladder in your patio. He says, can we do that? And I said, that's no problem. He says, yes, but we need to put it right where that tree is. Do you mind? Can we move that tree? And I said, oh, no problem. You know, you can move that right over there. Okay, there we go. There's the spoon. There. And that's what it does.
Wow.
The palm is so warm.
Oh, and it's warm, too. There's heat in it. And this was not a trick spoon. Now, why does that work?
It's hot. Because laughter raises the vibrational energy. When we laugh, we're very powerful. You just don't reason. Everybody could do this. I'm not special at
this
all.
Explains why, when I was a comedian, many times the microphone would just bend in my hand for no reason. So, actually, it never bent, which means maybe I wasn't as funny as I thought I was. Now, this is a stack of money in front of you. You actually talk about physically or connecting with money.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
I love this.
You're going to love this.
Money.
My students will love this, too. All right. Money is wonderful, and we want to, if we would like to have it, we need to really have a great relationship with it. We want to fall in love with money. Most people really have a funny thing about money. They really don't want to think too much about it. They're sometimes taught not to like it very much. And yet this is the biggest problem with people is they really need it, but they have an adversity to it. So what we want to do is we want to start to make a relationship with it. Start really falling in love with it. Feel it. Admire it. Okay, now take the money and just take it up to your nose. And it has a really distinct fragrance. And smell it.
Yeah.
And this really does because there's so much of it. Okay. Now, your subconscious gets the senses, and it gets it immediately. And so there's no bypassing it. It gets it immediately. It smells it. And with a smell, it will create from a smell because it has to be created in there first before it's out pictured here. So you smell it, and at the same time, what you want to do is you want to say, I am at one with a tremendous amount of money. That's what you want to say. And it really will work, and it's that simple. So after a while, you're going to learn how to do this, and you want to keep doing this. I'm at one with a tremendous amount of money. You keep doing it consistently. You're going to be amazed at how much money will keep appearing in your life. You'll start to realize you're very magnetic towards money, and money does not become such an issue any longer.
So psychologically, in other words, the irony of this is that if you will make a concerted effort to make contact with the very thing we spend so much time avoiding, eventually it will come and become less of an... Carol Dore. Carol? This is a very appealing topic. Now, there's a stack of money in front of you. You actually talk about physically or connecting with money.
Yeah.
What do you mean?
I love this.
You're right. I love this.
Money.
My students will love this, too. All right. Money is wonderful, and we want to, if we would like to have it, we need to really have a great relationship with it. We want to fall in love with money. Most people really have a funny thing about money. They really don't want to think too much about it. They're sometimes taught not to like it very much. And yet this is the biggest problem with people is they really need it, but they have an adversity to it. So what we want to do is we want to start to make a relationship with it. Start really falling in love with it. Feel it. Admire it. Okay, now take the money and just take it up to your nose. And it has a really distinct fragrance. And smell it.
Yeah.
And this really does because there's so much of it. Okay. Now, your subconscious gets the senses, and it gets it immediately. And so there's no bypassing it. It gets it immediately. It smells it. And with a smell, it will create from a smell because it has to be created in there first before it's out pictured here. So so you smell it, and at the same time, what you want to do is you want to say, I am at one with a tremendous amount of money. That's what you want to say. And it really will work, and it's that simple. So after a while, you're going to learn how to do this, and you want to keep doing this. I'm at one with a tremendous amount of money. You keep doing it consistently, you're going to be amazed at how much money will keep appearing in your life. You'll start to realize you're very magnetic towards money, and money does not become such an issue any longer.
So psychologically, in other words, the irony of this is that if you will make a concerted effort to make contact with the very thing we spend so much time avoiding, eventually it will come and become less of an issue for you.
Although Carol DeRay does not encourage gambling, the producers requested that the money power vision be put to the test in this manner.
Today we're talking with people who say we all have the power within us to attract money. Now, we wanted to put the idea to the test, so we enlisted our next guest. Please welcome Sheila. Sheila, how did you get roped into this?
My husband's a producer on this show,
yes.
And I had planned with a good friend of mine 3 months ago, actually, to visit Lake Tahoe. And he asked me to meet with Carol, get a crash course, and see what would happen in the slot machines in Lake Tahoe.
Well, for starters, I guess it makes the whole trip a tax deduction, doesn't it? Which is good.
Not for me.
Not for you. Okay. What did Carol teach you?
She taught me basically what she had been talking about before, smelling the money, that laughter was a very, very important part, and visualizing that the money was yours and that it would come to you.
It's like a whole different attitude toward money.
It is.
Was this different than you had previously related to money before? I mean, was this different for you?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, it was very different.
Okay.
I would say especially the hardest part was the smelling money, because as you said, we're programmed from children, it's dirty.
Yeah,
don't touch it, don't put it to your face. So
exactly
once
right.
I got over that, the rest was
piece of cake. Were you the person in the hotel the night before washing your money with a hair dryer?
No, yeah. But I did have to put these techniques to work in public.
So yes.
It was interesting.
Okay, now explain how this experiment was set up.
There was $400. My friend got $200, I got $200, and we both went on opposite ends of the casino to play slot machines and just to see what happened.
And you used Carol's techniques and your friend
did not, yes. I used the techniques that Carol had given me, and she just went about her way as she usually would.
Using the money. Okay, good. Well, Harvey's Resort and Casino in Lake Tahoe was kind enough to let us experiment with money and the power of the mind. Now, they asked us to let you know that they don't endorse this system, but they were as curious as we were about what would happen when the laughing, money-sniffing lady came to gamble. Watch this.
I'm now smelling the money. I am at one with a great deal of money.
Sheila hasn't even started playing, and she is already becoming one with the money.
I would like dollars, please.
Okay. Are you lucky?
I am.
Marina Angeles is seated well away where she can't see Sheila's special approach to gambling.
I'm at one with a tremendous amount of money. There it is.
Sheila's start is actually a bit slow, while Marina, who has not been trained to attract money, begins by raking it in. Marina takes an early lead with a $160 jackpot.
Okay,
part of
okay.
Sheila's instruction is to play where the positive vibration attracts her. It's clearly not here.
I do my best on video poker. That's where I'm going now. Now, how do I get to the poker machines?
Over there, to the right.
To the right. I'm at one with a great, tremendous amount of money.
No, not one yet. As the morning wears on, Sheila does begin to appear to be attracting money.
Look! I got it, a flush!
I got $75 off of four of a kind.
I did it! A flush! Look at that!
Meanwhile, Marina watches her $160 jackpot disappear back into the machine, along with a portion of her original $200.
Have to have enthusiasm. I'm having fun, that's the main part. And I tell the machine that it always pays the jackpot, and that I feel the love that is in every fiber of its being, and also that I am one with a tremendous amount of money, and it's coming.
And the winner is Sheila, with a cash surplus of
$89.
Ching-ching.
And I lost $48.
Not a statistical impossibility, but it looks like Sheila may just be a money magnet in training.
Man, Sheila, a couple of times, you almost snapped. What were the final results again?
I walked away with $289, and my friend lost and had 140-something or other.
Okay. Now, what's interesting footnote here is that there was an even bigger payoff when you got home. Tell us what happened.
Yes, there was. I got back from Tahoe, and in going through the mail, there was a check for $1,500 that I didn't expect. It was a refund from an apartment we had rented, and the deposit was only $500, and I don't know where the other $1,000 came from, but I'm not questioning it. It's mine, and I'm not questioning
yeah.
it.
Yeah. Carol, what's your reaction to this story?
This is exactly what happens when you focus on money. Whatever direction you're going in, it's probably going to come in over here.
What do you say to people who feel uncomfortable with this? I mean, on the one hand, visualization and positive thinking is a good thing. I certainly believe we ought to feel good about the power we have within ourselves. But the apparent excess of sniffing money, I'm one with a great deal of money, seems really contrary to a lot of people's value systems. How do you respond to what seems like tipping the balance too far the other way?
You better start tipping it the other way, because there's just so many people that are tipping it so far the other way that they're canceling it out all of the time. They're saying, I don't have enough, I shouldn't be, I don't know where it's going to come from, I really need to pay my rent, but I don't know how, but I don't dare think about money because money's not good, all this kind of thing. And so it's something that we really need to start knowingly do.
Okay.
Did you feel stupid smelling the money and
yes,
being one with the money?
Yeah, I would say initially I did have to, as I said, get over the aversion to putting money to your face. You've been told that it's filthy and it's dirty. But as the money started to come, I got over it very quickly.
You laugh all the way to the bank.
Okay. But, yeah, I guess that's probably the best way to persuade yourself is that it really started happening. It seemed less ludicrous at the end than it did in the beginning.
Do it.
Are you using that now in your life? Are you smelling your money at home now?
I am. In fact, as soon as the show is done, I'm on a plane to Vegas.